Hello everyone, this is Mohammed, and I'm here to explain to you how to use PEBL, the psychology experiment building language, along with the experiment that I developed, which is SPAM. So just to get started, I wanted to show you how to download PEBL, and you can just go to the website of PEBL, which is pebl.sourceforge.net. And as soon as you land on the website, you can click the download link here, and it will show you the latest version and all the download links for it. Generally, I used the second download link, which downloads just a zip file, and I extract it and I use it directly. Otherwise, you can download the installer and install it. It might be easier. Or if you have an OS X, a Mac, you can just download the OS X installer. So as soon as you download the PEBL application and install it, you can open its folder. I recommend putting the SPAM experiment folder in here, inside the same folder of PEBL for easier access from the application itself. So you will receive probably a zip folder, just extract it in the same PEBL folder you have. This folder, you might be able to extract it through the zip file directly, or you can find it in your program files folder if you installed it through the installer. So as soon as you open the PEBL application, and I selected this run PEBL.bat. On Mac it might be different. You just open the application or something. So you are greeted with this screen, which is asking you to cite the PEBL application or donate to them. And I just choose the use without password. And okay. So you are greeted with this interface, which is the PEBL launcher. And in general, you will find on the left this kind of explorer. So you can go up folders or check the folders inside this PEBL folder that we just opened the application from. And you can navigate through these either two dots. It means up a folder. So this would go to my downloads folder here. Otherwise, you can open folders from here as well. So I'm gonna open the experiment folder, which is SPAM. And then you have to select the .pbl file. And this is the experiment file. This is the code for the experiment. And generally, when you start, you will see that there is a participant code. And you can either enter a custom code here, otherwise if you launch the application for the first time, it would be one or something. And if you click plus here, it will just add one to this. I think after you finish one trial of this experiment, you generally see this number increase by one automatically. The second thing is experimenter. So if you have multiple experimenters using the same application, you can use this one. So what we care about here is mostly the parameters. And if you click edit here, you can see the parameters that we have. And I'll show you what do these mean in a minute. The last thing is I wanted to show you is the screen size and the full screen button. And in general, you either want to launch the experiment. So let's try to launch this experiment, and I'll show you these options. To launch the experiment, after you select the .pbl file, you just select run selected test. And here it just opened a window with the experiment, and I just put random stickers here that you can use. So I'll try to like place the stickers in random places now, and I can just place all of them. Actually, this doesn't require me to place all, but I'll do it anyway because I think the experiment required this. Notice something if by mistake there is an overlapping stickers, and this might happen, you might need to separate them. The problem is if the two stickers are the same size exactly, they cover each other up. So you will need to check if you are missing a sticker by mistake. Generally, I hope this wouldn't be confusing. So after I place all the stickers, I can click done. And as soon as I click done, you see that the participant code here increased by 1. So we were in participant code 10. And if you go back to the experiment folder, you will find that data folder inside the spam folder here. And this folder has all the recorded data from the trials that were run. So here you can find, so this is the participant number, and here you can find the CSV file that has the data you need. And these are the data points of each sticker, which is the X and Y. So this is the X position, and this is the Y position for sticker one, the first sticker. And this is the X and Y position for the second sticker. If you open this in an Excel application or a spreadsheet application, you would see it in a better arrangement. And then comes the distances between each sticker and the other. So this is distance from sticker 1 to 2. This is distance from sticker 1 to 3, and so on. And these are the distances, probably, as you see. So what are sticker 1, 2, and 3, and these numbers? This comes from the sticker numbers in the stickers folder in the experiment folder. So if you open the stickers folder, you can see that I numbered the stickers that are needed in numbers. And you generally want to have the same consistent numbers for the experiment you're running, because you are going to depend on this number to recognize that this is this sticker. So in general, if you replace these photos, you're gonna have to know which is 1, which is 2, which is 3, and so on. The other thing is, these stickers are right now, if you check its size, so I think if I open it here, I guess if you open it in a paint or something, you are gonna see the size of the sticker. I guess not. Where is it? Yeah. So for my paint here, or any other graphics application that you can use to edit your stickers or create them, these stickers are 50 pixels by 50 pixels. And you are gonna need to change the application's parameters to recognize the size of this sticker. So this is 50 by 50. So if we go back here to the PEBL application, you are gonna see that sticker dimension is 50, which is this number. So if you change this, it's best if you can change this as well to the corresponding sticker size. But beware that this interacts with the screen size as well. So generally, I recommend sticking with the same value, which is 50 by 50. And then generally, I'd say if you are running the experiment with children or kids or something, and you need to be sure that it's a full screen experiment, I'd say try to choose 800 by 600 resolution or screen size and select the full screen. And if you run the experiment like this, you're gonna see that, sorry, actually 800 by 600 is kind of smallish. I'd say you can choose the 1024 by 768. If we run it now, yeah, I think that's more manageable. Generally, yeah, as you have seen, if you select a small resolution, it's gonna be overlapping. Make sure you pick a resolution and the sticker size that can fit the screen nicely, generally. So all these interact with each other. So yeah, I'd say if you stick with the stickers, 50 pixels by 50 pixels, you generally can stick with the screen size and full screen. The other parameters I wanted to look at is the number of stickers. Parameter, you can change this as well to be less or more than 15, whatever number you want. And this needs to agree with the number of stickers you put in the stickers folder. So if it didn't find any number from 1 to 15, it's gonna be giving me an error saying that you are missing a sticker. And if you change the number of stickers files you put here, you generally can change it here easily. The other thing is the grid size, which is the size of the grid that you can place the stickers in. This is 10 by 10 grid. You can change it to be a different size, definitely. So that's all for the parameters. And I guess the last thing I can show you is maybe... I can show you how to use, how to use the data that you collect from this. So generally, if you open a spreadsheet or an Excel application, you can just import the data, and then I'll just upload it here. If I go to data, my first participant, and then I can just upload this. And generally, it's a CSV file, so you can load it in your R program or Excel application or whatever you choose to process your data. And I'm gonna just choose it as a new sheet and a comma separated file. And then just import the data. I just wouldn't convert anything. As soon as you import, you can see the better representation of the data. So again, as I said, this is the X and Y position of the first sticker, X and Y position of second sticker, and so on until all the numbers are done, 15 stickers. And then comes the distances, which is the distance between sticker 1 and 2, 1 and 3, 1 and 4, and so on, with all the permutations between the stickers and each other. So I guess that's it. If you have any questions or if you have any modifications on the application, feel free to reach out to me. And thank you so much for being with me.